Let us pray. God, open our ears to hear your word. Open our hearts to receive your word. Open our eyes to see your hand at work in the world around us. And open our lives to the infinite possibilities born of your love. Amen. Oh, that you would tear open the heavens and come down, so that the mountains would quake and the nations would tremble at your presence. These words from the book of the prophet Isaiah speak so much to the condition of the people called Israel. We believe that this text comes from a time when these people who have been exiled, who have been banished from their land, who have been scattered and tossed to and fro, are now trying to make sense of returning home and making a new life in the place from which they have been sent. And now is a time for judgment and justice, right? So all of these folks who have besieged us and mistreated us and been cruel to us and enslaved us, now is the time. Come down, tear open the heavens, break it all apart. Come down, come down. And make everything new. It's a great, great image for us. This image of the Almighty, this image of the Messiah, the Promised One, coming in and setting right all the things that have gone wrong. But from the time that we place these words post-exile until the time that that Promised One actually comes to earth in the flesh to live among us and to die as one of us, more than 500 years will have gone by. That's a long time in the memory of a people to continue to believe that the Messiah is indeed coming. It's a long time to continue to believe. We need to trust, we need to obey God's word. It's a long time to continue to believe that God's promises are going to be fulfilled. But that is exactly what is being asked of this people called Israel. Continue to believe, even though you have no reason right in front of you to believe it. You continue to believe God's promises. And you continue to believe them until that Messiah embodied, walking among us, is there. Now, if the people called Israel had hoped that Messiah was going to come riding up with a sword on a mighty steed, ready to take recompense against everyone who had ever assaulted or beleaguered them, that wasn't quite the way it all turned out. Messiah didn't come on a mighty steed. Messiah didn't come wearing armor. Messiah didn't come wielding a sword. Messiah did come wielding a sword of words, because this no-holds-barred truth-telling Messiah that came, who preached and who taught and who healed, dared to shake everything up. Everything. He dared to stand up to the authorities, the Roman authorities and the Jewish authorities. He dared to sit down with sinners and tax collectors. He dared to go near Gentiles that he wasn't supposed to touch. He dared to proclaim favor on those who had long since been shoved to the margins. That might not have been exactly the Messiah that everyone had hoped to see. But when God shakes things up, it's not always in the ways that we might like to predict. And so here we are on this first Sunday of Advent, looking at these very powerful lessons that we see from both Isaiah and from Mark's gospel. Because it's actually Isaiah that Jesus quotes in this passage from Mark's gospel, where again we're being told about things being shaken up, things not being exactly what we expect, things being made new. And oh, Jesus says, the hour and the day that the Son of Man is going to return, well, that you won't know. So just be ready. Stay awake. Stay awake so that you don't miss it. So when the Master comes, you're not accidentally asleep. That's a big challenge for us, because we all like our sleep. We all want to rest. We all feel like we're better when we're rested. This idea of staying awake sounds like sleep deprivation. How are we supposed to stay awake? At some point, we're just going to get tired. Our eyes are going to get heavy. How do we stay awake? How do we prepare ourselves for this new thing that God is doing? That's why Jesus tells us that we need to stay awake, because it's hard. It's hard to always be mindful that what's going on with God is not what we predict or expect. We can't put God in the boxes into which we'd like to place him. But instead, our hearts have to be open, our lives have to be open, so that whatever it is that God wants to do with us, through us, because of us, we are ready for God to do. And this notion of Messiah, the Messiah who was, who walked here with us, who died as one of us, the Messiah who is, the Messiah that we meet at this table every time we come into this place, the Messiah that we see when we look into the faces of one another, that Messiah is also the Messiah to come. And it's as hard for us as it was for the people called Israel to keep our eye on that prize and to realize that we too are called to remember God's word, to obey, to follow where God leads us, and to believe God's promises, even when God's promises seem so incredibly far away. We are called to believe them. And we're called to stand firm and to stay awake. Now, why is it special this day that we are hearing these lessons? Why is it so important to this worshiping community this day to hear these words? 83 years ago, a group of Christians, a group of Episcopalians, wanted to worship in Germantown. And they boldly and courageously decided that $1 at a time they could build a little chapel and make it a church home. And by God's grace, it grew. It grew because of faith. It grew because of love. It grew because of mission. It grew because people believed that God had a purpose for us in Germantown. And that purpose has sustained us through these 83 years, as we have continued as a worshiping community to try to embrace what it means to follow God's call, to serve God's people in this community. It's been a journey because it's taken us through three sites. We've almost made a full circle back to where we started. It hasn't always been easy. There have been difficult days. But God has kept God's promise to this place. God has kept God's promise to this worshiping community that if you are faithful, I will be with you. I will be with you no matter what. And God has remained with us. 10 years that we have been in this place, and we have seen our ministries explode. We have seen God's call to us move us in ways that we might never have anticipated and that we might never have believed, but we followed and we listened and we discerned and we did what God asked us to do. And God has been with us. And God has been gracious. But there's never an end to that story. Because God is always doing exactly what Isaiah said. God's always breaking things open. God is always calling us to say, what now? What next? What do I need you to do next? How do I send you into the world next? God is always doing exactly that. There's no getting comfortable. We want to. We want to get comfortable, but there's no getting comfortable because God is always moving in us and through us, and God is always making new things happen. And so as we celebrate 10 years of being in this marvelous space where God has just taken us to so many incredible places, we also have to be aware that God's not done. There's more to come, and we will continue to discern, and we will continue to pray together, and we will continue to grow together, and we will continue to open our hearts to the places where God would have us go, because those new things that God does with us, well, we don't know when they're going to happen. They do sneak up on us like the thief in the night. We don't know. We don't know what's next. We don't know where God will call us. We don't know what ministry God has in mind for us. What we know is that we have to stay awake. What we know is that we have to be alert. What we know is that our hearts have to be prepared and open for all of the places that God will take us. And the one who was and is to come will be faithful, will supply our needs, will love us, will call us, and for that, we say, thanks be to God. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.